Welcome to Cook 30. I'm Jeremy Dixon from the Revive Cafes in Auckland, New Zealand, and also author of the Revive Cafe Cookbooks. And today, I want to share with you some delicious cafe-style meals that you can cook at home. Cook 30 Food is all about using great plant-based whole foods. We're going to use protein sources like nuts, beans, and lentils, whole grains like quinoa and brown rice, and tie it all together with produce, fruit and vegetables, and lots of international herbs, spices, and flavours. And the best part about Cook 30 Food is you do not have to spend hours slaving away in the kitchen to make it. In the next 30 minutes, I'm going to show you a delicious meal that you can cook for your family that is healthy and they will love it. Today on Cook 30, we are cooking a delicious meal in 30 minutes. We have a Hungarian goulash with tofu, and we were serving this over lemon-infused quinoa. We have an amazing sweet chili roast vegetable salad, and a fresh Mexican salad. And to finish it off, we have a banana date smoothie. Okay, to make meals in a hurry, you've got to make sure your kitchen is well set up. We've got the jug on, water boiled, the oven's on at 350 Fahrenheit, or that's around about 180 Celsius. Pots on the stove, hot, ready to go. Clear workspace, sharp knife, chopping board, and the pantry and fridge are loaded with all the great healthy ingredients to make the meal. So first job off is the roast vegetable salad. And we're going to start with some roasted vegetables, and we're going to start with the hard ones first. So we've got some butternut pumpkin and some kumara or sweet potato. So a good fast way to use the butternut is cut it in half. This end has the seeds, so we'll just put that away and use it for something else. And we're just going to chop this end that doesn't have the seeds. The skin is really soft and beautiful when cooked, so we're going to keep that. And we're just going to chop it up into cubes, probably about an inch or 2 centimetres wide. This is a pumpkin or butternut is delicious when roasted. All the beautiful sweet flavours come out of it. I'll put it on a roasting tray. And we're going to do some sweet potato or kumara. You can choose whatever colour you want or combine some different colours. Again, just into cubes, similar sizes. This is one of the original salads I put on at my cafe when I first started around about 10 years ago, and it very quickly became one of the most popular salads. Again, a good sharp knife is good here, and again, make sure you're rocking your knife. We're not going downwards, we're rocking it to get the most use of the blade. So there we go. Any bigger than that and they'd take too long to roast, but those should comfortably become nice and soft in around about probably 10 to 20 minutes. Just going to do just a drizzle of oil, and I prefer to salt my things when they've been cooked, so we're not putting salt on at this stage. Just give them an even coating, just like that, and we'll put them in the oven. Now we've got some more vegetables, and these are the more slow cooking vegetables. We've got some red onion, some bell peppers or capsicum, and some zucchini or courgette. And we're going to put these on a different tray. These will probably only take about 10 minutes or so to cook, so we want to make sure we take these out first. If we cook them together with the pumpkin and the sweet potato, they'd overcook and the other ones would undercook. And again, we're just going to just cut them into similar sizes and put them onto the tray just like that. Bell peppers, just into half. I'm going to cut these into chunks. So you notice we're keeping everything similar size, not necessarily a similar shape, but just a similar size, which always goes well in a roast vegetable salad. Some vegetables I generally don't use, or a vegetable I don't use, is potato. Potato is a great vegetable, but generally I find a roast vegetable salad is nicer without potato. So just a general rule of thumb for you. Make sure you economise on your cuts. You can cut things really fast. Probably going to use half a red onion. This is a massive one. Cut the ends off. And again, just into chunks like that. Really, really quick. On the tray, drizzle of oil. I'm just going to toss it around again. And put that in the oven as well. So it's important to get that job out of the way because that's one thing that can hold up your meal, so get that in first. I'm going to serve it with some quinoa. Quinoa is one of my most favourite grains to use. It is so healthy, full of protein, and the best part about it, it only cooks in 12 minutes. So if you want a good rice type grain to use, quinoa is amazing. So we're going to use 1 cup, just check this is not too hot, it's nice and warm. So 1 cup of quinoa. I'm using a big cup. To 2 cups of boiling water, and this just boiled recently. So 1 to 2, same as rice. Look at that. And a few rules with cooking quinoa or rice as well. Number one rule is lid on. This is the absorption method, so we want the water to be absorbed into the quinoa rather than escape out the top. So lid on. Second rule is bring it to the boil until it's bubbling, and then turn it down to a simmer where it's just bubbling, and then that's where your 12 minutes start. Another rule, third rule, is resist the temptation to stir your quinoa. Basically, it will form little air vents, and that's what cooks it. If you start stirring it, you interrupt that process and it doesn't cook evenly. So quinoa's on, that'll boil in a few minutes, and we'll turn it down to a nice simmer. So there's 2 jobs out of the way, roast veggies done, quinoa underway, and we can now focus on the easy parts. Okay, let's start the goulash. First ingredient of any good hot pot or this style of dish is a nice sweet or brown onion. Just removing the skin is the most difficult part. And just going to combine this with a bit of garlic just to get the nice base flavours of the meal underway. If you start a meal with a good base, then finishing off tasting great is easy. Just going to roughly dice these. Guys, bit of oil in the pan. I'm using a cast iron pot here, which is my favourite way of cooking. So if you can find cast iron, it just has a great even kind of heat surface to use for your cooking. So I'd recommend you invest in something like this. However, any kind of non-stick pan, that's a good one. Or even a pot's fine, or a wok. So you can use any dish you want. So just find a good one. And again, my preference for these type of any kind of kitchen equipment is buy one really good item rather than buy 10, average or poor items. So save up and get something good that'll last you the rest of your life. It makes you enjoy your cooking as well. Better get some cloves of garlic, 2 cloves of garlic. Just put the garlic in the crusher, squeeze it through into the pan like that. Okay, get rid of these. Now mushrooms over here, and those onions are really strong. I don't normally buy chopped vegetables, but I was in the supermarket last night and these are actually really fresh, so I thought, why go to the bother of chopping them when they're pre-chopped? So we have 8 ounces or about 200 grams of mushrooms, just some pre-sliced mushrooms. So you can actually occasionally find some good sliced vegetables, but do make sure it's of good quality. So we're just gonna let that sit there, and that's gonna just reduce down, flavours are gonna come out, the moisture's gonna disappear, and we'll come back to that and add some flavours later. Meanwhile, the quinoa, that's bubbling away, we'll just turn this down, and just down to a very, very low heat, so it's just bubbling. It's now salad time. I've got a great Mexican salad that's so quick. Now I'm going to use a baby spring mix here, which is just a mix of different lettuces, and you've got beetroot, bits of beetroot, all these really, really nice little lettuces. So that's going to form the base of it. And you can get these at most supermarkets. Make sure they're fresh. Baby spinach, all that type of thing. You could use watercress, but just any kind of nice green leafy base for the salad. So we're going to start at the end. We're going to start with the dressing. And we're going to make the dressing in the bowl to save some washing up. So we've got the juice of one lime and one lemon. So we'll just juice those in this juicer. I like limes because they don't have pips, but lemons do, of course. Well, these limes don't have pips. So just pour that in there. Just strain the pips through my fingers. Yep. Two made it in there. Get them out. Come on. I'm going to put in a tablespoon of some good virgin olive oil. And two tablespoons of sweet chilli sauce. And just a little dash of salt. And I think that's all of the dressing ingredients. I'm just going to give it a stir around. So you could make this in a separate cup if you wanted to, but just it's easy enough just to make it at the bottom of the bowl. There you go, nicely mixed. Other ingredients we're going to add, we're going to add some whole kernel corn, just from a corn, from a can. Just drain the water out. And this is a great ingredient to have in your pantry. Adds lots of colour to any kind of dish. And we're going to add some tomatoes, just some baby cherry tomatoes. And you've got some yellow ones. And some red ones, just for a bit of extra colour. Never hurt. And we're just going to slice these in half. Again, try and slice a couple at once. That way you're going to do, I try to go aim for three. That way you can have a third less time slicing. And you can just slice them any way you want. Lemon as well. I'm going to put some cilantro or coriander as well, just chop up some extra flavour, like that. And a new ingredient you might not have used before is celery seeds. And these little guys, have a look at this, are just little seeds that you would normally plant to grow celery. And they have this most amazing, vibrant celery flavour that just bursts in your mouth when you eat it. When you give it to someone who doesn't know what it is, they're like, wow, what is this? So I'm just going to put some of these in as well. Put about a teaspoon. They're pretty flavoursome. I'm just going to mix this around. Get that lovely dressing over these ingredients. Just like that. Is that everything? I think it is. And we're just going to put this lettuce on top like this. And what we're going to do is just leave it there like that. And just before we serve, we're going to mix it around. If we mix it around now, the dressing is going to start to wilt the leaves. But if we mix it just before we serve, it's going to be a lot fresher. So all we need to do is mix it around and that salad is finished. On today's menu, we have a delicious Hungarian goulash with tofu. We're going to be serving it on lemon-infused quinoa. We have an amazing salad, sweet chili roasted vegetables. We have a fresh Mexican salad, and to finish it off, a banana date smoothie. So we've made really good progress. The roast vegetables are in the oven, they're probably nearly ready. The goulash has been started, the quinoa is probably nearly finished, halfway through. Salad is finished, and now we're going to finish the goulash. So this is all nice, getting nicely fried here, look at that. Everything's reducing down and becoming nice and sweet. Might just turn it up a little bit. And we're just going to add some thyme, which goes really well with mushrooms. So you can use dried thyme, but I've found some fresh thyme here today. And with fresh thyme, basically just kind of pick off the edges of it. And so you just in big clumps like that. If you get some stalk, that's fine, as long as it's a stalk at the end, which is nice and soft. So just get as much as you can, pick up all those nice soft tips. Try to avoid any of the, the hard, woody, rooty stems. But if you pull it off like that, if the stalk comes off on the end, it's normally soft enough anyway. So just like that, chop it up, just to give it some extra smaller pieces. I'm going to put that in here, just to add a little extra burst of fresh thyme flavour. That's great. Okay, we're going to add some canned tomatoes. So we'll just open these, so two 400 gram or 12 ounce cans. And you can use chopped tomatoes or whole tomatoes, but if they're tomatoes and water, you might want to think about blending them. There we go, look at that, nice smooth. So I'll put that in there. We're going to add some salt. A teaspoon of salt. Just a touch of cayenne pepper. Again, leave it out if you want, but just a little bit of, just a touch of heat. Won't necessarily make it hot, but it'll just give it that, it just kind of rounds out the dish somehow and makes it delicious. A tablespoon of honey or date puree. And that's pretty much nearly it. So we'll stir that together. Those are all the flavoursome ingredients. And the main protein event for this dish is tofu. So just by tofu, we've got 16 ounce or 450 grams. The quantity doesn't need to be exact. Just drain the water out of it. And it's really great. You can find tofu at pretty much all supermarkets these days. Of course, any Asian stores as well. And we're just going to cube it up into cubes. Again, economise your cuts, so you only have to cut things a minimal amount of times, and just into half inch or 1 centimetre cubes like that. I'm going to stir that in like that. So it's a good base of the garlic and the onion, the mushrooms, and just probably another five or ten more minutes on this dish and all those flavours will start to mingle. And then we'll just finish it off at the end with a garnish and some coconut cream. Okay, those roast vegetables are smelling amazing. We'll just check if they're done yet. Oh, look at that. I'll pull out the shorter cooking time ones. And these guys, I think, just need another couple of more minutes. So we've got those, they're out, ready to go. So we'll just put them on the bench just to cool down. And we'll wait till the other vegetables are finished and then we can make the roast vegetable salad. So I think the quinoa is finished now. Let's just have a look here. Pull the lid off. Oh, look at that. As you can see, it's just beautiful and fluffy. So we'll just, as you can see, just fluff it up and it's just beautiful, fluffy quinoa. There's no more moisture at the bottom and it's ready to go. Now I've cooked probably about twice as much and that's on purpose. So what I'm going to show you is basically when you cook this type of thing, put it into a plastic container or any kind of container for that matter and store it in the fridge and then you can use it next morning as a breakfast or a couple of days later in a stir fry or something like that. So there we go, put it in the fridge and just something to keep to make your next meal easier. Stramane and quinoa we're going to flavour. We promised lemon infused. So I've got a nice lemon zester here. So we're just going to zest the lemon into the quinoa and the pot that it's in. And this will make lovely shards of beautifully fragrant lemon citrus kind of flavour. So you probably want to use around about 2 lemons and try to avoid your finger because it generally doesn't taste good in quinoa. Okay, there we go. Look at that. On the back of there, all that beautiful lemon zest that we can now sprinkle through the quinoa. Okay, to add to that, oops, it's hot. Some lemon juice. So we'll just juice some more lemons. So we'll put the lemon in as well. So put the juice of 3 fingers, just to catch the pips. And this will definitely be lemon infused. Just a sprinkling of salt and a touch of oil. And then we'll just stir that up and then present it in a nice bowl. And that is ready to serve. Come on. And that just turns something what is quite an ordinary dish into something that's just more beautiful and fragrant. Okay, I'm going to make a lovely dressing now for the sweet chili roasted vegetables. Pan on the stove here, nice and warm. I'm just going to add some lovely ingredients to this. It's just going to make this dressing really special. So again, going to lemons. Lemons is a great ingredient to really just add zing to any kind of ingredient or any kind of dressing. So in the pan, we're just going to add some, going to add the lemon juice. Hope this won't splatter too much. And it pips through my fingers. I'll get those pips out later. We're going to add some sweet chili sauce. About 2 tablespoons of that. Tablespoon of oil. 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And 2 tablespoons of grainy seeded mustard. We're just going to stir that around, and that is going to create just a lovely little dressing. I'm going to add some water, so you probably want about 1/4 cup, just to give it some extra liquid as well. Just turn the heat up a bit. Get those naughty lemon pips out. Okay, that's better. I think that's all our ingredients, so that's just going to bubble up and just thicken slightly for a nice dressing. Meanwhile, we'd better check how the other vegetables are going in the oven. Aha, look at that. They are looking gorgeous. So push them down. Yep, they're just nice and just soft. So what we're going to do is put them onto our platter that we're going to serve from. All very hot, so make sure you use a good tea towel or some oven gloves. And these ones here as well, this is cooled down now. Again, we could mix this in a bowl, but you generally damage your ingredients every time you use a different bowl or a different receptacle, so try to minimize your handling of all of your items. Look at those beautiful colors there. Looking wonderful. I'm just going to take this dressing and we're just going to just drizzle it over just like that. And that is a beautiful dressing. And top it off, we've got some Italian parsley. We're just going to slice up and give it a bit of greenness on top. Push this over and that salad is now ready. Doesn't that look beautiful? Okay, let's make this really quick and healthy dessert. We've got a banana date smoothie. So we're going to start with 1 cup of milk. And there it goes, measurements on the blender. And I'm using almond milk, but you could use any other healthy milk you've got. 2 bananas, put them in there like that. And we're going to use 10 dates. I can only find chopped dates, so we're going to add around about 10 worth of chopped dates. Gives a sweetness, and 2 cubes of ice just to add a bit of coldness as well. And we're going to put that there and we're going to blend. Well, that's going. I'm going to add the coconut milk over here. And this will just finish off our goulash beautifully. That. Stir in that coconut milk or coconut cream and it comes out beautifully, nice and creamy. So just a bit of a garnish when you put it on the table and that is all finished. I'll just mix up this here. those beautiful colours coming out there. And try and land all the yummy ingredients on top like that. There we go. Bring out all the colourful ones. Look at that, nicely dressed. Finished, 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 finished. And I think this is now finished too. Look at that, a nice smoothie. It's very nice and dark. So we're doing four servings. Look at that. And just to finish off, just a bit of a pinch of nutmeg, just to give it a bit of something extra and a bit of interest. Just a bit of a sprinkle. And the dessert's finished. There you go. 30 minutes, you can achieve a lot if you use some great skills and techniques in the kitchen. Let's take it over to the table. And there we have another delicious meal in just 30 minutes. The lovely Hungarian goulash, bursting with flavours, served with the lemon-infused quinoa. You'll really enjoy that one. And this salad, which is one of the most favourite at my cafes. Just look at these amazing colours and textures that God has made for us to enjoy. They're just beautiful. And people eat with their eyes, so it's really important to cook with a lot of colour. And of course, the Mexican salad, bursting with flavours and freshness. And the banana date smoothie. Thank you for joining me today on Cook 30. I hope you enjoyed it and learned some new skills. And I look forward to seeing you next time.